Hi, I'm Carly McAvoy. This is adding sign numbers, second lecture on this. So the quick refresher from the first lecture is when we add two numbers together that have the same sign, we just add the numbers. We don't have to worry about canceling out or whatever because they both have the same sign. So negative 10 and negative 13 is going to be a bunch of negatives, and it turns out to be negative 23. I wanted to show you on a calculator, and I'm using a TI calculator. If I wanted to put this into the calculator, I can't put that in using the negative sign, the minus sign, because that's not what that means to them. So I want to put that in this way. I want to put in a negative from down here at the bottom, and then 10, and then plus. And that, if I put parentheses in there, that's fine, but I don't need it for this. And then I'm going to do a negative again, 13. Some calculators, you put the 10 in, then you hit the negative. You'll have to just play with your calculator and see. And then just hit enter, and it'll show you your answer, in this case, negative 23. Of course, math teachers around the world would like you to be able to do these kind of problems without a calculator, but if you're going to use a calculator, I want you to use it correctly. And you have some number and you add zero to it, that's called the additive identity. Nothing changes, so that's still just going to be negative 5. And most importantly are the types where you have some positives and some negatives. So you ask yourself, what do I have more? You have more negatives. How many more? 2. So that's a negative 2. Here, what do I have more, negatives or positives? We have more positives by 3. It's actually a subtraction problem once you decide what your sign's going to be. What about when you have opposites, 10 and negative 10? Well, those two cancel each other out completely, leaving no sign, which is the 0 term. And then finally, number 6, what do we have more? We have more positives. Our answer is going to be positive. How many more positives? 16. All right. So what I want to add in addition to that for this video is, what if you have a string of them, like negative 4, plus 8, plus negative 11, plus 9. Well, one way to do it is just to work it left to right. So you would start off and say, what's negative 4 and 8? Well, I have more positives there, so I'm going to have positive 4. And then I would go to the next two. What is this going to be? Well, this is going to be more negatives. More negatives. How many more negatives? Well, I have 7 more negatives, so I get that. You might not be as good at mental math as I am. I have had 30 years of practice. That shouldn't stop you from doing the problems. You just spend a little more time figuring out the differences. And then I'd say, finally, what do I have more of? I have more negatives or positives. I have more positives. How many more? 2 more. So that's going to be 2. Now here's another way, and this is how I actually work these problems. I don't do it the way I just showed you, but that works too. What I do is I add together all of the numbers with the same sign. I add together all my negatives, and I add together all my positives, and then I combine those once. So how many negatives do I have? Well, I have 4 and 11 more, so I have a total of 15 negatives. How many positives do I have? Well, I have 8 and I have 9. 8 plus 9 is 17. So I have 17 positives. And now I finally say, okay, what do I have more of? Do I have more negatives or more positives? And you can see that I have more positives by 2. I find this to be less work, and I just like it better. But of course, you can do what you want. Let's say I have 17 plus 4. Plus negative 8, plus negative 5, plus 10, and I wanted you to simplify that. You can work it left to right, that's totally fine, or you can work at the method that I just showed you. You should try it anyway and then see how you do. I'm going to use my method, and that is to, and I mean my method, not like I invented that or anything, but the method of my choice, and then I'm going to add all the positives, then I'm going to add the negatives, and then I will see what I have all together. I can do this in my head, 17 plus 4 plus 10, but if you can't, then you just use your calculator. It's okay in my class anyway, anybody who's in my class, to use a calculator whenever you need to rely on it. Now look, I got 191. Could that possibly be right? Look what I entered, 177. You also need to be able to tell when your calculator is giving you something that doesn't make sense. And it did write what I put into it, but that wasn't the actual problem, right? So I have 31 positives. And then for my negatives, I have negative 8 and negative 5. All negatives, so they're going to combine up to be a total of 13 negatives. All right. And then I can say, what do I have more? Do I have more positives or more negatives? And if you're not sure, you can use your calculator. But, I mean, you should be able to say what you have more of. You have more positives, right? But if you're not sure the difference, you could say I have 31 and I'm adding negative 13 on your calculator, and that would give you a positive 18. Now, I'm not so worried if you can't do the bigger numbers in your head like that, but the numbers I'm talking about, something like 18 and 2, you should be able to come up with 16 on that without using a calculator. So try to do them without a calculator. Know that your calculator's there if you need it, and understand that you can combine all your negatives and positives instead of just working left to right, but left to right will work also. All right, have a fantastic day, and I'll see you.